वेलकम टू ओरिएंट इंग्लिश मीडियम स्कूल सोलापुर फॉर ऑनलाइन टीचिंग सेशन 2020-21। माई सेल्फ मिसेस लता कोडम। आई एम द टीचर ऑफ ईवीएस सब्जेक्ट।
स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न चैप्टर नंबर सेकेंड, द इंटर रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन लिविंग थिंग्स। Can you solve this riddle? An age-old tree with the thick, strong trunks gives us deep, dark shade from the scorching sun. Like an old man's beard with many strands, it has ropes for swing from every branch. Can you recognize the answer by seeing this picture? Yes, that is banyan tree. Which tree? Banyan tree. The needs of living things are met in their environment. We need air, water, food, clothes, and shelter in our day. Today, life to satisfy our needs. We get food from plants, animals, air. We get water from rains, rivers, lakes, etc. We get clothes from cotton plants and wool. The needs of all living things are met in their environment, that is food, air, clothes, water and shelter. All living things are interdependent on each other. There is a difference in the needs of each kind of living things. For example, the water that mouse drinks in an entire day would not be enough for an elephant even at one time. Think about it. A fish can breathe in water, but can a pigeon do that? A sheep eats the leaves of shrubs. Can a tiger do the same? Bulrushes grows in water. Can a lemon tree do so? The needs of different living things are different. The fulfillment of needs. What is fulfillment of needs? Living things adapt themselves, that is why survive or grow in those areas where all their needs are fulfilled. The basic needs of all living things is the same. Let's take the example of tiger. A tiger has stripes. A tiger lies in the wait for its prey among all tall grasses. Its prey cannot see it in the grass because of the strips. There are animals like the deer, the nilgai, and the bison in the grassland. When the tiger is hungry, it can feed on them. For a tiger, there also needs to be a water hole nearby which never dries up, even in the summer. There must also be dense vegetation, tall grasses or caves in the hills or mountains in the area so that the tiger can find shelter. A tiger inhabits an area where all these things are available. Can you tell from where do we get silk? Silk is obtained from the cocoons of the larva of mulberry silkworm. How are trees useful for monkeys? Trees provide shelter, food and safety for monkeys. Monkeys adapted to live mostly in trees because
trees provide these resources which are necessary for their survival. How are trees useful for birds? Trees are a home for the birds. It provides shelter from rain and sun. For the birds, birds build nest on the branches. The next question, what happens if termites make a tree hollow? They weaken the trunks of the trees and make them hollow. That can cause heavy branches to break during storms and heavy rains. Such termite infected trees will eventually die. We keep animals in order to satisfy some of our needs. They become dear to us. We look after them well. We feed them. We take them to a veterinary if they fall ill. We get milk, meat, eggs, and several other things from the animal. Some animals are useful for carrying burdens or drawing carts. Domestic animals are also used to help with the heavy farm work in the field. Dog guards our house. Sheep gives us wool. Just as we need animals, we need plants too. Plants gives us food grains, vegetables, and fruits. We love flowers too. We use them for many different purposes. We get flowers from plant. We also get cotton wool from plants to make cotton clothes. We grow plants that are useful to us methodically. We sow seeds. We make sure that they get water. We give manure when necessary. We spray pesticides if they are attacked by insects. Plants satisfy our needs by giving food grains, vegetables, fruits, flowers, etc. Other living things also get their food from the environment. For example, chameleons eat insects when they are hungry. Some snakes eat mice and frogs. The cattle eat the grass. Beyond human beings, even other living things also get their food from the environment. Arboreal. What is arboreal? Arboreal, this word comes from the Latin word arbor, which means tree. Arboreal means living in tree. Animals like monkeys and squirrels live on trees. It gives them certain advantages. Being at a height, they are better to able to defend themselves from their enemies. Besides, they can eat the fruits of the trees to satisfy their hunger. Such animals are said to be arboreal. Unknowingly, they help the trees with whose support they live. As they move around here and there in the surroundings, they spread the seeds of the fruits they have eaten, though their droppings. Because of this, new trees grow in different ways. Some types of birds. To find trees useful for building their nests. Can you tell the seasons in our India? Summer season. In the summer season, we wear cotton clothes and drink plenty of water, and we use cotton clothes. Rainy season.
In the rainy season, we use umbrellas or different kinds of raincoats and hoods to avoid getting wet in the rain. Winter season. In winter, we wear woolen and other warm clothes to protect ourselves from the cold. Just as these three seasons affect us, they affect all other living things too. We use these changes taking place in the living world every year, year after year. Winter in Maharashtra is also called the season of Pangal. The falling of leaves. That is because many trees shed their leaves in winter. The coats of many furry animals became thicker in winter. This keeps them warm in the cold season. Such growth of hair is specially noticeable in the animals like sheep and some types of goats and rabbits. The end of the winter is also the time for mango trees to start blossoming. These blossoms are called mohur in Marathi. In this season, many trees get new leaves. In summer, the market is full of mangoes and watermelons for us to buy. This is the season for these fruits. Although the mango trees grow all over Maharashtra, our Konkan region is particularly famous for its mangoes. It is also the season for cashew nuts. The red yellow cashew apples can be seen growing on the cashew trees on the hillsides in the Konkan region. Rainy season. In June, black clouds make their appearance. The rainy season is a short way away. By this time, we begin to get jackfruits, jamuns, and karwandas. The seeds of grass and other plants lie scattered all over ground. They sprout and start growing as soon as it begins to rain. It becomes green everywhere. This greenery is smoothing after the hot summer month. Sometimes we can even see the rainbow with its seven colors in the sky. As it becomes wet everywhere, the frogs appear. We also hear the loud noise of frogs croaking all together. As the rainy season ends, it is time for winter to make the comeback. It gets colder and colder. This is not good for the frogs. They go deep underground for a long period of slumber, which lasts for 7 or 8 months. We depend on agriculture for food. The different seasons, summer, winter, and monsoon, are the time for doing different tasks in the field. What we have learned from this lesson? The need of all living things are met in the environment. There are differences in the needs of different living things. Some arboreal animals like monkeys and squirrels live in the trees and feed on them. Their droppings help trees to grow in the new places. Some birds build their nests in the trees. Each type of living things thrives where all its needs are fulfilled. For example, tiger lives in the grassland and aquatic plants live in water. Next, changes in season affect living things. In winter, trees shed leaves and animals' coat grow thicker. At the start of summer, trees get new leaves. In the rainy season, it becomes green all around. Frogs appear and crops grow in field. Okay, students, have you understood about this lesson? will meet you in the next period again.